sports broadcast live from the capital city of California, Sacramento. Welcome, everybody. Kevin Harlan here with Mark Hillel and Steve Kerr and the rest of our terrific 2K crew. Just under 3.5 minutes gone here in the first quarter.
Well, you know, the Mavericks got back into the playoffs last season after missing the playoffs in 13. This is a team that expects to be a playoff factor aside from that one season. Not missing the playoffs since 2000.
And for the Kings. And a bit of good news for this young man. He was offered another 10-day contract by the team as they want to get an extended look at him.
And, you know, just the fact that they want to see more of him really is a good indication that he's doing the right thing. I think he's on the right track in trying to maintain his momentum.
Harris kicks to Ellis. Minu, the pass to Ellis. Out to Harris. And it's Ellis penetrating. And he gets it to go.
They haven't been able to stifle him defensively here.
No, their offense continues to click.
Here's Kane, guarded by Harris. Thompson sets the pick for Gay. And the officials will call the illegal screen right there. This year is turning out to be. Let's check out the West and see how the standings look. Take a look at the Mavericks. They're seventh right now. Not a bad spot, but certainly they'd like to string together a run of wins. And of course, the Sacramento Kings, 9.5 games behind.
Well, right now for the Mavericks, the thing with them is they haven't really established an identity for themselves as a team. They never have seemed to come up with a plan and stick to it for very long. They've been all over the place in terms of their identity.
Yeah, I'd put that on the coaching staff more than anyone else, Mark. A coherent strategy has to be in place, or it's impossible to climb up the standings.
Let's see how the Kings have performed over the last few weeks. Fifth in field goal percentage, fifth in opponent offense, and they're in the top 10 in fewest turnovers per game. And they really do emphasize taking care of the ball.
Now, to me, this game comes down to one thing, and that's creating high-percentage shots time and again. And, Clark, you talked about that field goal percentage. That's an impressive number. So this is obviously a very well-coached team. They play hard. They play together. They're shooting the ball well like they have been. They're tough to beat.
Chandler Parsons signing a 3-year, $46 million contract offer with the Mavericks. This past season, Clark, everyone expecting him get a nice raise, but he's making max-type money.
Sometimes it's a matter of timing, Kevin. The Mavs clearly value him highly, and at the same time, they weaken a division rival, so it's a win-win as far as they're concerned.
There's 47 seconds left here in the first quarter. Here's Kane. Hands the shot from the wing. Kane's got 5 points so far. Parsons still pretty young, with time to improve, has the size to play as a power forward in certain lineups, and a good spot of three-point shooter, especially from the corner.
Certainly is.
Felton dishes to right. Back to Felton. Five to shoot. From 17 feet out. No good on the shot, a bit long that time. Passes it to Stauskas. Shoots from 12. And again, it's Sacramento converting.
That bounce pass got him the ball in rhythm. Nice play.
And here is Harris. He had a 12-point outing in their last game against Golden State.
He got some huge points from the foul line, too, Kevin. He's very aggressive, generating contact and drawing fouls. And he's not their first option, but not a bad fallback either.
So far to the first quarter as our second quarter gets underway. And let's quickly break down the game we've seen here, guys, from the Mavericks.
Good start for this club. I like the way they played together, really moved the ball and did a nice job offensively.
Yeah, excellent ball movement. It's paid off on the scoreboard, too.
On the floor for Dallas, Kirk and Chandler up front. Harris is out there at Jameer Nelson. And it's Aminu in at the small forward position. The Kings trailed by 11. Here's Kane. He's coming off a 16-point game against Golden State. He sinks the 11-footer. James got his third bucket of the night.
Good job there, Kevin, getting himself a little space on the inside.
Harris with averaging 8 points a game. Nelson with a screen on Sessions. Harris kicks to Nowitzki. High post drive. Kane grabs the board.
Well, as far as jump shots go, that's as high percentage as it gets.
Up with Doris Burke. Hey, Doris.
Well, guys, Monte Ellis joined the Mavs last season, and Coach Rick Carlisle said, we love him. He's been a godsend. He fits what we're doing. He fits with Dirk. He's been extremely coachable, and he's a rise-to-the-moment player. Just a great competitor. Kevin, they've made great use of his slashing ability.
The best offenses in the league, Doris. Thanks. And Nelson gets it to go. Nelson's got his first points in this one. The Kings trailed by 9. Here's Kane. He's got 7. And the rebound goes to Nowitzki. Nowitzki's got 3 rebounds now in this one. Now, here is Nelson. He's covered closely. Aminu, averaging 6 points per contest, just 4 to shoot. Steps back and shoots, and it hung on the rim, but wouldn't fall for it. Stauskas, the best to Kane. Feet to Cousins. Let's it go from 11. That's good on the jump shot.
Very clever passing. That was just beautifully done.
And we're now a little over 2.5 minutes into the second quarter.
Last season, the Kings inking DeMarcus Cousins to a big 4-year contract extension, and he rewarded them with the best season of his young NBA career, setting career highs pretty much across the board.
Well, it was the Dallas Mavericks in their last game, a loss to the Warriors in Oakland.
I didn't like the defensive game plan they had going into that one. It seemed out of whack, the matchups were wrong. They didn't bring the energy necessary either.
You know, it was befuddling to me why they stuck with that, Steve. I mean, they dug themselves a hole, and then they didn't make the changes they should have to get.
Good ball movement.
And Rudy Gay is subbed in. Close game as we wrap up the second.
Well, Tyson.
Okay, guys. We got a few minutes here. Let's go.
Welcome back, everybody. The start of the second half. The Mavericks leading. Landry and Cousins patrol the paint. Sessions out there with McLemore. And it's Gay in at the 3. That's the 5 out there for the Kings. Nelson kicks to Ellis. Some nice passing here by Dallas. Nowitzki dishes to Chandler. Nice D from Cousins.
Near the rim. We saw it there. Defense offers just a little bit of resistance. It doesn't take it up quite strong enough.
Kane, he's checked in for Sacramento. And for Sacramento, they're shooting well. 50% from the floor. Kicks it to McLemore. McLemore off the pick from Kane. 6 on the shot clock. No good from Cousins.
Really good offensive execution. Nice pick, just couldn't get the shot to go.
Boy, you love to see that as a basketball purist. Guy setting a good screen and then getting the shot opportunity.
Ellis can't get it to go.
That's terrific defense right there to prevent from converting in close.
Kane passes to Kane. Tries to keep it alive. Now Nelson. Averaging 10 points per contest. And we're about a minute and a half here into the second half. And that is good. Nelson's got his second bucket. The Kings trailed by 3. Cousins with a screen on Nelson. Pass to McLemore. the pick from Kane. Six to shoot. Andrew with the screen. It's off the screen. Kane, that's good. Kane's got 11 points.
How about that? Gets it off right in the face of the big fella. Quick release.
And operating on the perimeter like that negates some of the height disadvantage, too.
Dishes at Nowitzki. Back to Nelson. Nowitzki sets a screen for Nelson. Parsons on the wing. The basket good off the assist from Nelson. Nelson's got assist number 5 here tonight.
Oh, he's going to keep banging those home if you give him that much space.
Kane, the best to get. Cousins with a screen on Parsons. Kane drives in. You've got an advantage there off the pick and took it right in. He's got 7.
And their offense is flowing. It's clicking right now at the beginning of the second half. They've made 3 of their first 4 attempts.
To the left wing. Here's Nowitzki. And it's wide right. It's off the rim. The Kings trailing. Talk about the great European players in NBA history. Dirk Nowitzki, Steve, has to be right at the top of the list.
Well, without question. Another distinction, you know, for Dirk is possibly the greatest 7-foot shooter in basketball history. Actually, I think he is. And then with that high release, you know, his jumper is about the closest thing to an unblockable shot, as we've seen, you know, since maybe the sky hook back in the day.
Landry with a screen for Gay. Stops, whistling what looks to be an illegal screen.
Yeah, good call there. You could tell he was moving into the defender.
The Kings shooting at 51%. Really solid.
You know, you mentioned the sky hook. Dirk has actually been working on a version of that shot with his lifelong German trainer. Still tinkering with his game and looking to add to it even now. And he's surely going to be a Hall of Famer. That's part of the reason why he doesn't stop working on improving.
On the floor for Dallas, Monte is the 2 with Parsons playing the small forward. Brandon Wright is out there with Chandler, and it's Nelson in at the 1 spot. The drive by Ellis. High shot from 10 feet out. Ellis has got the lead up to 12 now for the Mavs.
Well, the fans already heading for the exits, clearly not pleased with the way their home team played here today.
And they shouldn't be pleased. I mean, it's a very well-deserved win, Steve. They came into this building and weren't in the middle.
I've been rapping for about 17 years, okay? I don't write my stuff anymore. I just kick it from my head. I'm saying I can do that. No disrespect. But that's how I am.
Into this one after the win against Phoenix.
And Kevin, I thought they put together a fantastic offensive game plan in that win. They knew exactly how to exploit the defense, and they really got on a nice roll.
And exploit them they did. See, they were relentless. They kept so much pressure on the defenders over the course of that game.
On the court for Sacramento. Up front, it's Thompson and Cousins. Sessions out there with Ben McLemore. And it's Gay in at the small forward position.
Well, he's been working hard to get good work.
The Jazz making a switch here. Jackson's checked in. Kane, he's checked in for Sacramento. And I think Doris Burke has something for us right now. Doris?
Kevin, I had a chance to catch up with Quinn Snyder. He said a big part of their focus defensively will be on trying to contain Rudy Gay, adding, he presents challenges because he can shoot over the top and also has a tremendous finisher inside. We've got to force him to that left hand, but I'm hoping we won't have to double too much because they have plenty of other guys who can knock it down. Kevin, the
Thompson. Okay, in the basket again. Chance there to take the lead, missing.
Rudy Gay traded twice in the last couple of seasons. Really, it was his big contract that led to him being dealt. Because Gay is a quality player, but the feeling was his production was not going to be off.
And for Gay, traded from the Raptors to Kings in December. Really, he had one of his best seasons once he was in Sacramento.
Good checked in for Burks. Reggie Evans, he's checked in for Sacramento. Stauskas comes in for Sessions. Kane, the best to Gay. Thompson sets the pick for Gay. And he wills that one in, sinking right through off the back iron. Guys in Sacramento, Rudy Gay shooting well and passing better. And Steve for the season did a good job of getting to the line.
Yeah, and I think he might have read some of his critics in terms of his game. He's been picked apart in terms of his shot selection and sort of things. So that efficiency is exactly what a lot of people have been clamoring for.
Good, can't get it to go.
He tried that leaner, and to me, it probably got him off balance a little bit. Probably should have gone straight up.
Stauskas with the bucket.
What a start to this game. The offense is so dominated.
I tell you what, feels like a game on the playground. Forget about defense. Just keep firing.
Here's Exum, and he lays it straight in.
He's so good at recognizing where the openings are and getting the ball to the rim.
The Kings trailing. About 7 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. And the officials will call the illegal screen right there.
Well, if you're going to set a screen like that, you've got to make sure your feet are set.
I agree with you, and I thought maybe he was set that time, Steve. I thought it was a good screen on his part.
The dish to Gobert. He set the pick. Here's Hood. He's been patient so far, and nothing yet on the scoreboard. A nice shot by Booker.
The mid-range jumper becomes a pretty high percentage shot for him when he has that kind of space.
Here's Kane. No good, and tight defense there bothered that shot. And so that's the end of the first quarter. Offensively. Down some numbers here, the hustle stats for the Jazz.
Boy, they've really amped up the pressure at the defensive end, guys, and have piled up the steals in the early going.
And the other thing I like is defensively, they're causing turnovers, and that's allowing them to get into transition.
In a moment now to reset the lineups, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up for the second quarter of basketball. On the court for Sacramento, Kane, he's in at the point. Ian Allens is out there with Evans. Then it's McLemore. And it's Stauskas in at the three. And the second free throw, good.
Well, the Utah Jazz enjoy what has long been considered one of the best home court advantages in the NBA here at Energy Solutions Arena. And combine the altitude with these rowdy fans, tough place to get a road win.
They set the pick. Cantor kicks to Hayward. Shoots from the high post. Count that one. Hayward's got 10 points in the game. Here's Kane. 11 points for him in that last game against Dallas. And it's blocked. A time for the ball. And out of bounds as you're talking.
Better than that.
Not tonight, I'm not.
And so. Sacramento's gone 1-3 from way outside since the start of the second quarter. Gay outside. Can't tie it up as that one's no good.
There was just enough defensive pressure to get him off balance and cause that shot to go awry.
1-12 left for the first half. Exum kicks to Gobert. Good screen. Here's Hood. Looking for his first basket still on this. Six to shoot. Novak misses.
You've got to like what they've been doing down there in the low post part.
I do. I love it. Their rebounding has been outstanding. So important in a tight game.
Teardrop shot. That's good. Hood's got his first 2 points of the night. 40 seconds left in the first half of the game.
You know, with the time left, they can trade 2-for-1 here.
If they hurry.
The screen from Thompson. Kane, the pass to Gay. And that misses. That would have put him up. For the Sacramento Kings, the last game lost to Dallas.
They found themselves up against a hot team that night, Kevin, and they just didn't have the manpower defensively to shut them down.
You know, guys, I expected a little more fight out of them than what they showed us. They never strung together any stops like they needed to.
Here is Nova. He's covered by Gay. The offensive rebound. Gobert. And so he draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot two.
Nice work to get inside and draw the foul.
Yeah, it's obvious. Defense is not going to allow many easy layups. They're going to make you earn it from the line.
Good on the second free throw.
The two-possession lead is what they were looking for there, so they can deal with that one miss.
On deep, Gay. Second quarter ends in a...
All right, listen up, everybody. The second half...
Welcome back, everyone. Changes here for the Kings. Collins has checked in, and Stauskas subbed in for Rudy Gay.
Rudy Gay is listed at 6'8". He has a 7'3 wingspan and tremendous athleticism. Really helps him defensively, both on the perimeter and inside, where he can fit on the glass and blocking shots.
Burks the off guard with Hayward. Ennis Kanter is out there with Favors, and it's Bird at the one. That's the group right now for Utah. And let's get this update now from Doris Burke, who's across the way on the sideline.
Hey, Kevin, during that last break, I heard Mike Malone as he addressed his team. He went over the offensive lane, and then it hinges on running through McLemore. Coach is looking for big things from him throughout the rest of this game on the offensive end. A lot of the scoring burden will fall on him. Those are likely not the last adjustments they make today, guys. There's still time left in this one. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks again, Doris. Utah's been blank from three-point land so far in the third, still 0-for-3. As you talk about Rudy Gay's size and athleticism, Steve, he can play small ball 4 in a pinch.
Yeah, and it also enables him to get that jump shot off over pretty much anybody. So if he's spaced and he's playing at a 4, he can get that jumper off. Now he's got the ability to drive past it because the floor is opened up. So very interesting when he's placed at that 4 position. I wonder what the score of this game would be if they weren't pulling down all these rebounds.
Love what I'm seeing from them in the paint.
Now the pass to McLemore. And no good. Had a chance to take the lead.
I don't know if it's just defense. Look, the step slow since the start of the quarter. The shooting has really suffered.
And here is Bird. He's got 7. Up top, Burks. He's covered by Kane. The baseline jam. Favors can't get it to go.
He's tried to get it going, but the shots just have not dropped for him today.
For the lead, and he connects with the jumper. Stauskas has got 7.
Well, we've seen that more than a few times. An easy bucket in the lane.
Yeah, the interior defense simply has been lifeless.
And Favors gets to Hayward.
Shot the ball exceptionally well as they've built this lead for themselves here.
The Kings trailing. They set the pick. The Kings have shot 10 of 13 from the free throw line.
For this season, guys, from the free throw line, they're shooting 77%.
So Utah ends up going with a new group. Sacramento making a switch here.
They should be in front right now, but he'll be relieved not to have come up totally empty there.
Exum dishes to Nova. The feed now to Exum from 12 feet out, and that one's good. Exum's got his 3rd bucket of the night. The King should bring his lead and something to be desired, just 36% here in the third quarter. Kane, the pass to Gay. And so he draws the foul on the shot, a trip to the line to shoot 2. so Gay nails both of them.
Well, you can count on him, can't you? He seems to knock down free throws consistently all game long.
Exum gets to Hayward. Gobert dishes to Exum. Pass to Hayward. Ooh, offline. Tie game in Utah. We're going to step aside for just a second, but join us right back here for the start of the fourth quarter next. And it's time to bring up the state assist of the game.
Well, it had to be this play, don't you think, Kevin?
Sure.
This is just a phenomenal pass. Made the defense look like no idea what was going on.
What precision with that pass. On the court right now for the Kings, Kane in at point guard. Rudy Gay is up there with Evans. Then it's Thompson, and it's Sessions in at the two. Here's Gay. The shot's good. Sessions making him pay. And that's 18 points for Rudy Gay. Utah trailing here. Exum with it. He dishes it to Hayward. Feeds it to Gobert. Sacramento grabs the miss.
He's always going to have a difficult time finishing when the defense is in his face like that.
And he gets it to go. Now it's a four-point Kings lead.
Boy, he made a nice little bounce pass there. We call that the pocket pass, and he did it well.
Exum kicks to Gobert. To the inside. And Hayward gets it to go.
I'll tell you what, you don't want to allow too many of those kinds of baskets with the game on the line.
Now, this is when defenses have to protect the basket with everything they've got. Force the offense to shoot from the perimeter.
Kane, the best to Evans. Novak grabs the board. For Utah, they've gone 1-3 from the field to start the fourth quarter. Exum dishes to Gobert. Hayward kicks to Gobert. It to Hayward, and it's a defensive 3-second violation. And a moment here to take a look at the scoring breakdown for Sacramento.
Like it.
All day long.
And then look at the points.
Utah's gone 1-2 from 3-point range here in the fourth. Now, here's Exum. And so it's Utah. Sessions. First quarter of play with about a minute and a half gone. Setting the floor for the Suns. Thomas is out there with Dragic. Then it's Miles Plumlee. Then there's Scott. And it's Green in at the three slot. And Plumlee kicks the drive. And up the court come the Kings on the break. Thomas with the block. Caruso on the shot. Took the foul. Shot misses. He'll be shooting two. Sacramento shooting their first free throws of the evening. And that drops, so they now lead by one.
Carl Landry parlayed a strong season with the Warriors in 2013 into a four-year deal with the Sacramento Kings. Missed the first half of the season with a hip injury, but being healthy, he's instant offense.
Not really to start day one, and they missed three of their first four shots in the field.
Shoot 11 feet away. That's good. James got his first points of the game. And his old high school coach is an attendee at today's game, Clark. I believe they still stay in close contact, even though he's now in the NBA.
You know, you always have to keep perspective by remembering where you came from, no matter what you're doing, but certainly in the NBA. And it's nice to see that he does that by still staying in touch with his old coach.
Here's Krogic. Misses in close.
Usually, if he gets to the rim, he's converting it into points. The defense stood tall there.
Shots good by Gabe.
That's exactly what they wanted to do. I mean, you'd like to see that every time down the floor.
They really want to find that igniter here.
Yeah, that's right. Kevin, the offense has basically been running in place.
We got to get going. Poked away. Stolen by Landry. Gay against Scott. Landry dishes to Gay. Nice again. Here's Kane. Persistence goes on as they finally hit a shot. Kane's got his second basket of the night. Suns trail by seven. Doris Burke has an update for us. Doris?
I caught up with Coach Jeff Hornacek. They're looking to break the tie on this season series, and I asked him what he thought might be a key factor. He said it always seems to come down to getting a stop. We have to get our hands up to contest shots, or as we often do, even send them back. That's how we'll win this game. Sounds like a plan, Kevin.
Okay, thank you, Doris. And the defensive approach, guys, how do you think that'll play out here?
No, Kevin, I'm not sure they should be more focused on their opponent than they are on themselves.
That is sort of the way it sounds, but still, I don't think a defense-first mindset is ever a bad thing.
Just trying to shoot. Near the three-point line, it's Thomas, and it's wide right. It's off the rim.
Rebound is going to be the focal point for them in this one, fellas. I can feel it.
Yeah, it's a physical game, and so far the numbers show that they've got the edge on the glass.
Kane, the best to Landry. He kicks it to McLemore. Passes it to Kane. Elbow shot. Count the bucket. Kane's got his third basket of the night right there.
It's been a very efficient first quarter for him. He's creating good opportunities and converting those that he creates.
Substitution here for Sacramento. Collins is checked in. Thompson comes in for Carl Landry. Evans, he's checked in for Rudy Gay. And Stauskas subbed in for McLemore. There's the pick. Here's Morris. Averaging 9 points per contest. Morris kicks the drive. Bledsoe outside. Shot clock at six. Shot. Good on the jump shot.
Don't take your eyes off of him because he can make plays from multiple spots on the field. Put the isolated cam on.
Here's Kane. Blanketed by the knee. Lights to the rim for the layup. Kane's got 8 points.
He's played an important role in their offense today, guys. Without him, they may not be in the lead.
Outside Dragic. He feeds it to Tucker. Out to the wing. What's the left side? Here's the teardrop. Throws it from deep. Shot is off. And so that's the end of the first quarter. Offensively, pretty stagnant. It's Sacramento. They lead by seven. And we'll be back with you for the start of the second quarter when we return. Here for Sacramento. Some changes for Phoenix. Just under 3.5 minutes played here in the second quarter. Landry and Cousins. Pistons patrol the paint. Mr. Perfect out there with McLemore. And it's Gay in at the small forward position. That's the five out there for the Kings. Here's Kane. He's guarded by Dragic. Andrew gets the bucket. And the Kings lead by 12.
Well, they've settled into a pretty nice groove here offensively in the second quarter.
Yeah, I like the way they picked up the pace shooting the ball. I mean, the field goal percentage upwards of 50% now.
Thomas, it's a wide open look. Hits from the high post. Thomas got four this quarter. Oh, no, he may have gotten injured right there. He's in a lot of pain.
Yeah, Clark, that did not look good. Let's keep our fingers crossed that it's nothing too serious.
Boy, you can't help but feel for him. One moment you're doing what you do best, and the next situation's really out of your hands. I really hope he's okay.
The Suns making a switch here. Bledsoe's checked in. Here's Kane. Here's Landry. And there's 2 points. Working on the glass, paying off that time. Landry's got the lead up to 12 now for Sacramento. 1:39 left in the second quarter. And Bledsoe, here we go. Green dishes to Bledsoe. Green with a screen for Bledsoe. To the middle. Here's Plumlee. The shot no good. Nice D from Cousins. Miles Plumlee, Steve, buried on the bench in his rookie season with Indiana. But the Suns saw something in him, and they would not sign off on the Luis Scola trade without Plumlee coming back in the deal.
Well, it was a good move on their part. Plumlee stepped into their starting center position, played very well, and has a bright future, really, in Phoenix because he fits right into what they're trying to do.
Gay with the block. Let's go to our sideline reporter, Doris Brook. Doris, what do you have?
Continues to grow, and the league is now considering moving the draft after July 1st and packaging it with a season-ending award show. Guys, it could make for some pretty exciting theater.
Doris, that'll be something. Thanks.
Well, it might not be time for guys like Durant to give a 15-minute acceptance speech, but I think it would be fun.
From 13, and the jumper is good. Gay's got his second bucket of the night.
And the Suns' top draft pick, Alex Len, dealt with ankle issues last season. That being the case, how big was Plumlee for the league? He's a big-time glass eater inside and an above-the-rim finisher to help force the D to collapse. He's a guy that I think has tremendous upside and extremely athletic for a frontline player.
And with that shot, the Kings lead is cut back down to 14 after they get the hoop from Bledsoe.
Great job of utilizing that screen and finding space to knock down the jumper. Good basketball.
Kane can't connect from 13 feet up.
That was not pretty there. You got to make that one.
And the first half is now in the books. Kings lead by 14.
Okay, fellas. Nice job sticking to the plan. And the.
Welcome back, everybody.
Let's see what you got, son.
Here. Collins is checked in. Thompson comes in for Carl Landry. Reggie Evans is checked in for Rudy Gay. And Stauskas subbed in for Ben McLemore. And it's time for an injury report. Let's get an update on Thomas. What's the status, Doris?
Guys, I was able to talk with the head athletic trainer of the Phoenix Suns about his status. It's bad news, I'm afraid. He's saying that it looks like a broken ankle, which can truly be a devastating injury. He won't return to this game.
Yeah, let's keep our fingers crossed and hope he's back out on the court soon.
Rehabbing is a tough process, Steve, and if any luck for him, it'll be a short one.
On the court for the Suns, we've got Marcus Morris. He's out there with Marquise Morris. DJ Tucker is out there with Bledsoe. And it's Dragic in the platoon.
You know what? That's what you like to see. A perfect pass leading him right into the shot. Didn't even have to break stride.
The Suns training staff renowned around the league for their ability to keep players healthy. They're at the forefront, biomechanics and all that new school stuff. The results have been terrific. It's called preventative maintenance.
Here's Kane. That drops. Kane's got 12.
Some defense. offensive breakdowns are starting to show up now. Their last four buckets allowed have come from very close range.
Giving up these easy chances is going to do wonders for their confidence.
Bledsoe, they recover. Morris with the bucket. 1:14 left in the third quarter. Thompson is screened on Bledsoe. In the corner, it's Session. Thompson sets the pick for Session. And here's the call. It's going to be an illegal screen. Now let's take a look at the teams that have been holding their opponents to the fewest points in the last 10 games. Number one, the Kings.
Well, they've been solid defensively. Maybe a little fortunate at times when teams have had off nights, but overall, pretty solid defense.
Goran Dragic is checked in for the Suns. Morris passes to Morris. Down to five on the shot clock. Oh, yes, the turnaround. Morris has got six.
Well, as for them being behind in this game, you certainly can't put any of it on his shoulder. He's been tremendous offensively.
Feeds to Sessions. Evans, a screen on Dragic. Here's Sessions. And good. Got the friendly bounce off the right side of the rim. 8 points for him.
You know, he was smart to draw his man out to the perimeter. He's giving up too much size to be effective inside.
Agreed. As long as he picks his spots, his outside shot will be hard to block, no matter who's on it.
It's 9 seconds separating the shot clock and game. Bledsoe kicks to Morris. It's hauled in by the Kings.
Tough D on the inside.
Put up a roadblock, a construction barrel right there. That's what he brings defensively.
Here's Stauskas. Here's Thompson. Here's Kane. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact and he'll shoot two.
And the defense looking to protect the rim at all costs.
Yeah, I like that. A foul to save the lane. Make him earn it at the line.
The Kings shooting their fifth and sixth free throws of the game. He's off on the second. And as we... We have a look at the State Farm assist of the game. And the Kings making a change here. Thompson's checked in. And then for Phoenix, Morris comes in for Scott. And it's Eric Bledsoe in for Green. Up front, it's Thompson and Cousins. McLemore is out there with Ramon Sessions. And it's Gay in the small four. That's the five out there for the Kings. Morris dishes to Tucker. Good ball over here by the Suns. Bledsoe for three. In coming off an assist from Dragic. Dragic has got his seventh assist of the game with that last one. Kane, he's checked in for Sacramento. Mike Scott's checked in for the Suns. Gerald Green comes in for P.J. Tucker. Here's Kane. The pass to Kane. In the corner, it's McLemore. Pass to Kane. Releases from 15. That's good.
They are not letting up. They just keep coming at them.
And I'd say that lead is too big to overcome at this point.
Now here's Bledsoe. Defended by Kane. Bledsoe passes to Dragic. And it's Plumlee that time on the assist by Dragic. Dragic has got his eighth assist in the game.
Well, what we saw here tonight is one team just had everything going for it and the other didn't. Huge margin of victory in Sacramento.
When you consider the difference in their field goal percentages, the team has to be happy that this wasn't a bigger loss. This team was on fire.
Yeah, you know what, Kevin? It's got to be frustrating to shoot so poorly when the other team is on fire.
And for the year now, they'll be tallying their 16th win.
Well, they've put themselves in the driver's seat as it applies to this season series. The win will give them a 2-1 edge with one game left.
And, you know, no matter what happens next time they meet, I think this was the biggest game they'll play against each other this season. Getting that 2-1 advantage means a lot.
Beyond the actual result of this game, I think fans are going to look back and see this was just a monstrous performance for McLemore. You have to look at his steals and when he would come up with them as major factors in this result.
Bledsoe kicks to Plumlee.
Good!
You know, if this had come earlier, they might have been able to get back into it.
Yeah, but as it is, too little too late.
Sacramento's gone 2-for-2 from three-point land to start the fourth quarter. Into Jason Thompson. Out of bounds. Phoenix will take possession.
Boy, that's embarrassing, because he's going to have a hard time living that one down later when they watch it on tape.
And the Kings will go for a different look here. Collins has checked in. Evans comes in for Thompson. Caspi, he's checked in for Rudy Gay. And Stauskas subbed in for Ben McLemore. 8-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Morris inside, off target with the jump hook. Here's Kane. Off on the layup. Here's Ennis. Offline. And so it's Sacramento easily grabbing this one. Some days, Clark, yep.
Gentlemen, I'm here with DeMarcus.
It's the man, the myth, the high school coaching legend.
No, not as good as a coach since I lost you a few years back. It's funny how coaches get better when they actually have good players on their team.
Man, forget that noise. You taught me everything I know.
You're like a sponge. And it's paid off for you. I'm so happy for you.
Thanks, coach.
I hit the showers. I can smell you from here.
All right, man, I gotta get fresh.
All right, sounds good.